Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about some problems that you're going to need to know if you're going into Math 141, which is pre-calculus. So this is a four-part series where we're just going to look at problems that you should have down if you plan to be successful in that class. Of course, you plan to. If you really want to be successful, you need to know these problems. This is a very simple equation here. We're going to distribute to get rid of the parentheses. Here we're going to distribute the negative, and then I'm going to simplify inside the brackets x and x, and then I'm going to distribute. I'm doing this quickly because this is a very easy problem that I'm sure that most of you will be able to do. I'm going to move the x's to the right, so I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. That's going to leave just x here, and I'm going to add 14, and that's going to be 23. So x equals 23. You know that if you want to check that, you would come over here and put 23 in where the x was, and if it's truly a solution, both sides of the equation will equal the same number. So I'm going to leave that for you to do, but you would go back, whoops, where there's an x, I want to put 23. And I'm going to let you go back and work that out to show that it's actually a true solution. Let's look at the next one. You may have equations like this where, do you see our problem right here? This 2 goes evenly into the 6, the 5 goes evenly into 30 and 20. So it makes it easy just to distribute the fraction here. But you may have problems where, let's say this is a 2 and this is a 7, and you couldn't just, it won't go evenly. In that case, you can clear the fractions out. I'm not going to do that on this video, but you can clear out fractions first. I'm going to leave these in. 1 half times 6 is 3x. 1 half times 6 is 3. The most obvious problem students have as they go through algebra is that they aren't competent with fractions. So if you have trouble with fractions, you need to go back and work on that, because it's going to stop you in your tracks, because you have to apply the rules of fractions in a more general sense later. And if you don't understand what you're really doing, you're not going to be able to just be able to use a calculator to get the answer, and you're going to be in trouble. Here I'm distributing negative 1/5 to both 30x and 20. 5 goes into 36 times, 5 goes into 24 times. And I had 2 negatives, that's how I got the positive. Now I'm going to add 6x to both sides. That's going to give me 9x over here. Here I have, you see I have 3 minus 5, which is negative 2. So I'm going to add 2 to both sides. And 4 plus 2 is 6. I did a little bit of hocus pocus there, but hopefully you're confident enough to see what's going on there. This is really not a video to teach you how to solve a basic linear equation. So if that looks daunting, there are other videos here on this YouTube channel that you can go back and will show you how to solve an equation. If I divide both sides by 9, I get that coefficient. Every time you get a fraction, you always want to reduce it to lowest terms. You don't want to change it into a decimal, but you do want lowest terms. Okay. One more equation. This one has fractions in it. I can leave the fractions in and work it with fractions, or I can clear out the fractions. The least common denominator is 25 for this problem, and so what I'm going to do is multiply everything by the LCD. So I'm going to multiply by 25. Remember, if I multiply one term, I have to multiply all terms. I can't just change one thing. So even though this doesn't have a denominator besides 1, we are still going to have to multiply by it. 5 goes into 25 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15, so 15x. 25 times x. Here the 25s cancel. 5 goes into 25 5 times, and I get 55. 15 minus 25 is negative 10x. And I'm going to subtract 1x from both sides, and that's going to give me negative 11x. And finally, divide both sides by negative 11. Since I have 2 negatives, I'm going to get a positive answer. And I'm going to get x equals 5. All right. So, again, a pretty easy equation if you're going into pre-calculus. If that looks daunting, then you want to consider taking Math 99 or an intermediate algebra class before you jump into that pre-calculus class. The last equation is very different because if I get rid of the parentheses by distributing, you can see what happens is I get an x to the second power. That's a quadratic equation, meaning I have x to the second power. So in order to solve that, I'm going to subtract 10 from both sides and set that whole equation equal to 0. Because I want to use the 0 property of equality. And the 0 property of equality says that if a times b equals 0, then a equals 0. Or b equals 0, or both. So what I'm going to do is factor this to get two factors that will equal 0. So this is again not a video about factoring. I have videos on factoring. If you'd like them, contact me. So x squared is going to go to x and x. And 10, I could have 1 and 10, or 2 and 5, but I want 3, so 2 and 5 makes sense. I want a negative 3, so I'm going to make negative 5 and positive 2. And now I have this a times b equals 0, and I can use that property. And so I'm going to say either x plus 2 equals 0 or x minus 5 equals 0. In solving those two simple equations, I get negative 2 and positive 5. So I have two different solutions for that equation. Let's take a look at 5. If I put 5 in here, 5 minus 3 is 2. 5 times 2 would be 10. That is a solution that works. What if I put negative 2 in here? Negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. Negative 2 times negative 5 is positive 10. There's two solutions to this equation because I had something to the second power. Up here, it was to the first power. I got one solution. So that's something to think about as you work through there. Okay, I will see you on the next video.